Savior, this God can hear you. Hallelujah. And hear your heart as you pray today.
Oh,
so when you come and approach, when we have Holy Communion today, I would like all of you that are in the 8th year grade, you believe in your heart that I'm going to this school, God is going to help me to this school, God is going to give me the marks for this school, God is going to be my salvation for this school. You need, don't rely on your knowledge, don't trust on your own understanding. No, you trust in God.
Allow God.
We were actually having a devotion and I was telling, Othaniel is in class 8, he's actually going on to form 3. And every day, as we have devotion, I'm always telling Othaniel, you need to believe in your heart. You need to trust in your heart and completely trust in your heart for that placement that you're looking for. And don't just trust on your own understanding. You trust God.
Yeah.
I know you're good. You get 80s, you get 90s in your exam from school. I don't want you to rely on those marks from school. I need you to trust in the living God because He's going to do that for you. And that goes for every children that are listening in today. Okay, Kukila, you're going on to Form 3. I would like you today to be part of the Holy Communion, to stand there, because some of you have set your test until Friday, and you're all done from primary school to go for your school break from next week on Friday. I need you to stand in faith and believe with us. For high school, for Maris, we still have those Form 4 students at home. For Joshua and Carlos, their exams still go on until next Thursday. So it can be some of you, you're still having your exams or your tests that you still have to do until next week. And yesterday we actually took a walk. Every Saturday morning we always go to the seawall with the whole family. Grandchildren from the eldest right up to the youngest. And it's always a good time for us to walk and pray. And I always tell them, when you walk, continue to pray. Say things out to God that you don't want anyone else to hear. It's just between you and God. And it has been a very, fulfilling Saturdays. So yesterday, after we did our walk, because we wanted to stay back a bit, and we went to buy breakfast to come back and have breakfast there at the seawall. And I asked my grandchildren, okay, ask what you people want for breakfast. And Joshua turned and he said, no, I'm fasting. Oh, okay. You're fasting until what time? So he mentioned his time. I said, Mara, you have a program. He said, I want to fast now until I finish my exam on Thursday, then I will eat normal again. And, you know, when we went to buy breakfast, and I want to share that and bring it close to you, wherever you're listening from, I don't force my children to go on fasting. I don't tell them, you must fast or you do that. No, I want them to desire it from their heart, because when they're doing it out of their desire, then it's more genuine to God other than them just doing it because I'm telling them to do that. So you need to put aside, if you are in high school or primary school, if you can, please, try and fast and have this closeness in the relationship with God, to completely trust in God that He's going to do that. And last time when we have a devotion, we didn't have any word. I just told them, we're going to have prayer today. And I allocated my grandchildren to be the word, the voice of our prayer to God. And I must thank God, you know, in everything. Because I have one of my grandchild, grandson, Israel. He's an RHD patient. And I continue to believe that one day when he goes for his checkup, he's going to be completely healed. So every time I go to the seawall, I'm always mentioning his name. And so last night I gave it to him and I said, Israel, today you will pray for the healing for our family. You will pray for your heart. You will pray for our life, pray for Pa, and pray for Othaniel's collarbone and everything. You have to pray for our healing. So as you teach them to pray, and children, when you're listening today, like what I said, kakoninda warakinana tungaketa, uikuma bakabota na matine lomu, wasabana lomu kalomu, masuwe kwa, bakabauti kwa, bleto na nobody else will do that for you, only God. We need to completely trust in God. And I would like us, as we have a Holy Communion today, that's for the children, because they're sitting on their knee, they're sitting on their, for adults.